Okay, guys, number three. I bought a new t-shirt from the clothes shop. Between brackets, I have to use the word wear. Okay? So, I start with the WH word, which is wear here. Then I have to put that katong, the auxiliary verb. Excellent. So, I'm going to look at the sentence. Is there any auxiliary verb here? I bought a new t-shirt from the clothes shop. Can you see any these articles, where, will, can you put? No, I can't see any. What will I do? I use one of the do words. Okay? I bought. I look at the verb. The verb here is? Excellent. Bought. The verb here is bought. Bought. Bought is in the? Which tense is that? It's the past simple. It's in the past form. So, I bought. So, bought is in the past form. What we use for the past form? We use the auxiliary verb? Excellent. Did. So, it's going to be where? Did. Where did, and I choose to be you. Where did you? Excellent. Where is the verb? So I have the WH word, which is where. The auxiliary verb, which is did here, because the verb is in the past. The subject, which is you. The verb, which is the main verb, which is why. Where did you buy? And you. I complete my sentence. And you. T-shirt. From. And a question mark. So, where did you buy a new t-shirt from? Okay, I have the WH word, the auxiliary verb, the subject, and the main verb, and the rest of the sentence, except for the answer. Okay, where did you buy a new t-shirt from? Number four, I have she likes pasta and meat. Between brackets, I have the word what. What am I supposed to do? I will start with the WH word, which is what? Extent. Then comes the auxiliary verb. She likes pasta and meat. Can I see an auxiliary verb? No. So I'm going to use. What do you think? Is it do or does or did? If I look to the verb, I have the verb, which is likes. Likes, which is like. And there is S added to likes. If there is S added to the verb, I'm going to use does excellent. So it's going to be what? The auxiliary verb we're going to use does. What does? Where is the subject? She, excellent. What does she like? What does she like? Excellent. And the question mark. What does she like? She likes pasta and meat. And pasta and meat are the answer. Is the answer. What does she like? I have the which word, the auxiliary verb, the subject, and the main verb. Why? Number five. I went to the hospital because I was ill. I went to the hospital because I was ill. Between brackets, I have the word why. So, as usual, I start with the WH word, why. After that, what comes after the WH word? The auxiliary verb. Here, do I have any? No. So, what I'm going to use, I look at the verb. The verb which is went. Went is the past form of go. Go. So we go, went. So here the verb is in the past form. So what I'm using in the past form? I use did. So it's going to be, why did what? The WH word, the auxiliary verb, the subject, which is I choose to be, you. Why did you, go, the main verb, why did you go to the hospital? Why did you go to the hospital? I went to the hospital because I was. Remember that? Why did you go to the hospital? So guys, I'm going to recap. If you can't find an auxiliary verb, you will go to the do words, which are do, does, and did. You use do when the verb is in the infinitive form. You use does when there is S added to the verb. And you use did when the verb is in the past form. Okay? Let's go to the next question. Rearrange the following sentences, okay? have 2 minutes in order to arrange them and come back to me. Pause your video. Okay, welcome back again. Pre-arrange the following sentences. As I have to read them. One, hunt for lion's food. Hunt for lion's food. Hunt. How we are going to arrange them?
Yeah,
accent lines. I start with the subject lines, huh? Then the verb, which is hunt. Lines hunt for food. Excellent. Number two. And tigers, ferocious. And lions, animals. Oh, how are we going to arrange them? Huh? Excellent, I can hear you. It's lions and, excellent, tigers. Yeah, lions and tigers. Or, excellent, lions and tigers are ferocious. Animals. Sorry, I can't find a space in the narrative here. Are ferocious animals. Thank you. Number three. Do get up every day. Time you what? So I have a question mark here. So I have to form a question. Don't forget that. So I start with the WH word. What time? What do you think? What comes next? What time? Yes, man, you take it. What time? What time, huh? Then comes auxiliary verb. Do. What time do, huh? Where is the subject? You. What time do you get up every day? What time do you get up?
What time do you get up every day?
Number four. I have much, she does have water drink, huh? So, look at the end, I have a question mark. I have to form a question. So, I start with what? How much? Excellent. How much? How much what? How much water? Yeah. How much water? Does? Excellent. She drink. How much water does she drink? Thank you. How much water? How much? The language word, and you said after how much comes the thing. The new thing I'm asking about is quantity, the auxiliary verb, the subject, and the new verb. How much water does she drink? Number five. Does the mouse wear hat? Here I have a question mark. I have to form a question, which is going to be where? Excellent. Where? Where hat does? Good. Where does what? Where does hide the mouse? Where the mouse hide? Yeah, the mouse hide. Where does the mouse hide? Where does the mouse hide? Thank you. Can you finish it?